Welcome back to Biology by Shravanti. Today we are going to discuss about the biotechnology. Under that, it is a part 3, which is nothing but methodology for recombinant RDNA technology, simple RDNA technology. So in previous video, we have learned about the tools involved and devices or different techniques which we have used in the biotechnology. So let us go into the topic or steps involved in synthesizing the or used in RDNA technology. So before going to your topic, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. So let us start the steps involved or methodology for RDNA technology, how they synthesizes. So first one is the isolation of DNA from the donor organism. Second step is insertion of desired foreign gene into a cloning vector. Third step is transfer of RDNA into a suitable component host or cloning organism. Fourth is the selection of transformed host cell. Fifth is the multiplication of transformed host cell. And sixth is the expression of gene to obtain the desired product. So these are the 6 steps which are necessary for the RDNA technology. Now let us learn deeply what the steps involve. So here you can see in the diagram the donor cell. So the donor cell which we have selected, we want isolation of gene. First step is the isolation of gene from the donor organism. So from the donor cell we have to isolate whatever gene or DNA we require, we have to isolate. So that particular gene we cannot take it from the host cell. So in order to that, we completely extract the DNA, and this DNA is break down into pieces, that is with the help of the restriction endonuclease enzyme. Already I have discussed about the restriction endonuclease. That means it cuts the DNA at a specific sequence or recognition site. So there it will cut the DNA into the small fragments. Now with the help of the restriction enzyme, the DNA which we have taken from the donor cell is cut it or break down into fragments with the help of the restriction endonuclease. So this is the fragments of DNA are obtained. Next, this side if you see, the vector is taken. So this vector may be a plasmid or bacteriophage which we have extracted from the prokaryote cells. So this vector is also break down at particular recognition site. That here also it use the restriction enzyme, like restriction endonuclease. That means it specifically identify the sequence recognition site and cut the fragment. Now this fragment of DNA is inserted into the vector, and with the help of the DNA ligase, which acts as a attaching or gum type. So when this fragment of the DNA is attached to the vector, so it gets completely sealed off. So this is the part. Now this is the target DNA which we have inserted in the vector. That is nothing but inside the plasmid. Now the host body, that is nothing but a bacterium where it starts to replicate. So this RDNA, so now this part we call it as RDNA, that means recombinant. We have selected, we have chosen the selected DNA and we have inserted in the vector. So that's why this one is called as the RDNA, recombinant DNA. Now this recombinant DNA is inserted into the host body. So once it is inserted into the host body, it starts to divide or selection of amplification process. Now the cell starts to divide from one cell to two cells, two cells to three cells. Completely the protein encoded by DNA is inserted. Nothing but all the proteins, whatever gene we require in number of copies, we will get the copies. So this is the steps involved in plenty of amplification takes place. So this is nothing but the same as the PCR. Okay, so this is the RDNA technology. So let us learn deeply about each and every step. So first step, as I said, isolation of DNA from the donor organism. So they need to be cloned. Okay, so that one we call it as the donor. So genetic material from the donor is removed and isolated and purified by using several techniques. An isolated DNA is now spooled with the help of a glass rod. Now the purified DNA which we have collected, it has to be cleaned by using the restriction endonuclease. So this one we have discussed about the in previous video. So after cleaved fragments may have cohesive ends or sticky ends or blunt ends. Already I have discussed about the sticky ends and blunt ends in the previous video. For that, please go on to the part 2. From the cleaved DNA fragments, a fragment containing desired gene is isolated. So entire DNA, now it has to be cleaved. That means cutting has been taken. The fragments of DNA is formed with the help of the restriction endonuclease. Now from these plenty of fragments, we have to select one of the fragments which we are deserve. That means which we want from that strand. So that one is collected. So this is nothing but is the isolation of DNA. Next, the part which we have selected or the DNA fragment which we have selected has to be inserted into the cloning vector. So for cloning vector, we have already chosen or said that plasmids are needed of which is taken from the bacteria or from the lambda phase or M3 from the viruses, and most commonly used plasmid is the PBR technology. So most commonly used plasmid is a PBR322. So the plasmids are isolated from the vector organism. Already we have discussed either from the bacterium or from the bacteriophages. So same way as we have done in cleaving of the DNA, so here also the vector has to be cleaved. That is taken place with the help of the restriction endonuclease. Now the vector DNA is cleaved. Now by using the enzyme DNA ligase, the foreign DNA, that means the DNA segment which we want to insert, should be placed, and that is attached with the help of the DNA ligase. This DNA ligase acts as a gum type and gets stick the foreign DNA with the vector DNA. Now the recombination of vector DNA and foreign DNA, or the combination of the vector DNA and foreign DNA, is now called as the rDNA or recombinant DNA, or also called as chimeric DNA. That's why this technique is called as the rDNA technology. Now this vector which or rDNA which we have selected is to be inserted into the cloning organism. So the host cells take up naked rDNA by a process of transformation and incorporate into its own chromosomal DNA, which finally express the trait controlled by the passenger DNA. That means the vector which we have to insert back to the host cell, it go and mingled with the chromosomal DNA and competed with each other, and it has to survive. The transfer of rDNA into bacterial cell is assisted by a divalent calcium ion. So calcium ions are necessary. So for this technology in plants, we use mainly the bacterium like Escherichia coli or Agrobacterium. So this competent cell which we have taken up for rDNA technology, so that competent cell we call it as the transform cell. So insertion, that means how we are placing this vector or rDNA into this into the host cell, that is with the help of the or by using the technique electrophoration or micro injection or a shoot gun, ultrasonification, biolytics method, etc. So mainly this technology, that is plant biotechnology, the transformation takes place through the tumor inducing plasmid of Agrobacterium tuminiferus. So next step, selection of transformed host cell. Now that is nothing but the transformation process generates a mixed population of transform. So it generates, so after plenty of vector cells multiplies and form plenty. So in that, the non-transform part will be and transform. That means recombinant one will be as well as non-recombinant one. So recombinant one we needed. So we need to isolate or we need to divide the cell separately, recombinant from non-recombinant. So that is taken place with the help of the marker genes. For example, PBR322 plasmid vector contain different marker genes. For example, so we need to differentiate the or we don't want the ampicillin resistant gene and tetracycline resistant gene. So when PST restriction endonuclease is used, it knocks out the restriction, or that means it removes the ampicillin resistant gene from the plasmid, such that or so that the recombinant cells will become sensitive to the ampicillin. So in this way we can induce them. So next step, multiplication of transformed host cell. Once the transformation, that means host cells are separated by screening process, and in this step the transformed host cells are introduced into the fresh culture medium. At this stage the host cell redivide along the replication and form the recombinant DNA by carrying themselves. So next, expression of gene to obtain the desired product. So next step involves the production of desired products, like when you want to produce either antibiotics you want, or enzymes, or alcohol, etc. So desired product, desired gene we have to express desired gene, we have to select it out. Finally, the desired product which we got is separated and purified through downstream processing using suitable bioreactors. So in this way, whatever gene we have inserted in the vector, either it may be antibiotic gene, or which may be the enzymes, or which may be the alcohol. So in this way we will amplify the genes of that. For simple example, if you want to produce the insulin, so insulin coding gene is introduced into the same vector. So that vector is re-entered into the host body, and in the host body plenty of the insulin genes are produced. So that insulin genes we have to select. So this is about the rDNA technology. So thank you for this session. If you like, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel.